Hier achter mij ligt Silicon Valley, midden in de staat Californië in de Verenigde Staten. En als autoliefhebber ben ik hier een beetje met dubbele gevoelens. Want als er één plek is in de wereld waar je nog ongegeneerd kunt genieten van auto's met 6-cilinder en 8-cilinder verbrandingsmotoren, dan is het wel hier. Behalve als het aan de bedrijven hier in deze vallei ligt, want die zijn hard bezig om de toekomst van deze auto's drastisch te veranderen. En dat maakt mij als journalist juist weer extra geïnteresseerd, want er vallen heel veel verhalen te halen. En daarom duiken we de komende tijd in Silicon Valley. Waar ligt de toekomst van de auto? Ditmaal gaan we op bezoek bij Mercedes-Benz, dat al sinds 1995 een onderzoeksafdeling heeft in Sunnyvale. Onder de vlag van Mercedes-Benz Research and Development North America, ofwel MBR-DNA, onderzoeken bijna 300 mannen en vrouwen elke dag hoe Mercedes er van de toekomst eruit zullen zien. Een toekomst die we bespreken met CEO Arvid Nistrooy.
We see how the digital world of every one of us as a digital user is changing. For example, one aspect. Today you don't buy a cell phone anymore and say this is my cell phone and I choose some carrier, but you buy a contract and the cell phone automatically exchanged every 2 years.
Right.
So you buy a service.
Yeah.
And you buy a service, be it with Apple, be it with Google, be it with whoever, and then you enter their digital ecosystem.
Is that the business case you're actually entering?
We are of course considering as the competition goes away from pure devices to ecosystem competition, what must be our ecosystem? Is it enough to just have a car that drives you from A to B, or that you drive from A to B?
Yeah.
Or is it not more important to allow to offer a real mobility ecosystem to the customer? It's going beyond just making a beautiful and fascinating and powerful and performant vehicle.
Right.
And efficient, of course. It has to be an overall offering.
Om uit te zoeken hoe dat aanbod er precies uit moet komen te zien, hanteert Mercedes-Benz de CASE-strategie, waarbij de letters staan voor connected, autonoom, shared en electric. Alle nieuwe modellen worden ontwikkeld aan de hand van die vier pijlers, waarbij technologie een hoofdrol speelt.
Connected means that the Mercedes-Benz customer can experience all the digital connectivity that he has in his everyday life, also in the vehicle. It starts with integrating your mobile device that you typically have seamlessly. It goes further saying or allowing the customer to, for example, use an Apple Watch, a door-to-door navigation app that we offered.
Right.
Have been offering now for a year where you talk to your Apple Watch and then the navigation information after you have walked to the car. The car takes over the navigation destination and it gives back to the watch for the last half mile. The future in connectivity will expand these aspects and make it more and more seamlessly in broader applications. Or if you look at the newest trend, artificial intelligence, machine learning becoming very strong, we're convinced that is a very important technology and very important opportunity to improve the customer experience. And that's, for example, what we use to make the car capable of predicting what the customer wants.
Kunstmatige intelligentie gaat dus een veel grotere impact krijgen dan we ons nu kunnen voorstellen. En het fenomeen loopt als een rode draad door het gebouw van MBR-DNA. Ook op hele verrassende manieren. Ja, dit is dus wel een heel duidelijk voorbeeld van hoe het werkt. Als ik hier once upon a time, een begin van een sprookje, intik, dan is de typewriter hier zo intelligent dat hij zelf de zin gaat aanvullen. Duurt even, dus hij is nu aan het processeren, zeg maar, aan het verwerken wat ik net heb gezegd. En vervolgens denkt de processor hier. Kijk, daar gaat hij. Kijken wat hij schrijft. A great festival in the world. Je kunt het vergelijken met een gebruiker van een auto in de toekomst die gaat zeggen, oké, ik wil koffie gaan halen. Dan gaat de kunstmatige intelligentie aan boord van je auto al bedenken, oké, hij wil straks koffie gaan halen. Dat kan hier, hier, hier en hier. Zet dan vast de navigatie en gaat door. Op die manier proberen ze dus met dit soort experimenten de auto van de toekomst slimmer te maken. De slimmere hersens van de auto worden straks ook gebruikt om de machines zelfstandig te laten rijden. Mercedes-Benz is een pionier op dit vlak, maar toch verwacht Arvid Nistrooy dat de invoer van autonome auto's geen kwestie is van een paar jaar. Daarvoor zijn de uitdagingen simpelweg nog te groot.
Purely the different traffic rules are already one thing, right? So we have to make sure that the local rules are always considered. And you can imagine a downtown situation in an Indian megacity is very difficult, very different from a downtown situation in whatever Norway or a Swedish city, right? Yeah. It is different. So we have to, we will see that the easier patterns will become available sooner and the more difficult a little bit later. Mm-hmm. And of course, there's the other parts around it, which are the legal situation. Exactly. We have to sort out that it is clear for everyone who is responsible for what.
Right.
Because decision making does not take place by the driver in the car anymore, but at the software development engineer's desk to some extent. Yeah. So we want to have the same understanding, what is right, what is wrong.
Is that the main reason we don't have autonomous cars yet, in your view?
It's not the main reason. I mean, there's also technological things like different sensors we need for this, and what is the cost of the sensor, what's the the cost effectiveness at the moment, because nobody has the scale yet, nobody produces these components already in a big scale, so it will of course change the cost. And there's also other aspects many people may not have yet talked about or thought about so much. For example, communication by the car to its environment. I mean, how does a pedestrian know the car is stopping because I want to cross the road?
Well, you've done some research with the F015 vehicle, right? That had some LEDs in the front and the back communicating to the people. Is that the way we're going?
I'm convinced there will definitely be some communication that is visible from the outside. If it's LEDs there, I don't think it will be acoustic to a big extent, a significant extent.
No horns going off.
I don't think so, but we haven't talked about blind people yet. And you may know in the development of electric vehicles, there's also a group of blind people saying, hey, what do blind people now do when the car is completely silent?
Yeah.
And it's not us alone figuring this out, but this needs discussion in bigger groups, governmental authorities and groups that represent the people, social experts to see what is the right way to go.
Naast verbonden en autonoom wordt de Mercedes van de toekomst ook gedeeld, volgens de experts in Silicon Valley. Op dit moment voert moederbedrijf Daimler met Car2Go al het grootste autodeelprogramma ter wereld en werkt Mercedes-Benz samen met Getaround, een soort Airbnb voor auto's. Vooralsnog lijkt het merk vooral aan te haken bij diverse initiatieven, omdat er evenveel oplossingen als klanten zijn.
I of course enjoy driving a Mercedes-Benz, no doubt.
Right.
But if you see me going to San Francisco airport and paying very high parking fee, I would rather park my car somewhere else and take an Uber for the last 5 miles.
Yep.
It's different applications that you will see and think. I think it mostly depends on the use scenario. What do you need at that point in time? If you want to travel to the airport with your family and you have 5 suitcases, you might want to take your big own SUV rather than waiting for a rideshare which needs a very big car.
Yeah.
And is Mercedes-Benz a company that should provide that kind of solutions?
Mercedes-Benz should be the company to provide the right solution for its brand experience that it promises and that it wants to deliver.
Mm-hmm.
And that, I think, since we are a luxury brand, goes beyond what everybody else does. So it will have special offers or special level or higher level of usability, of convenience, of making things easier for our customers, saving time. Time is a big luxury in the future, we are convinced.
And that should be the added value of using the Mercedes-Benz programs.
For example.
De laatste letter van de case-filosofie, de E, komt dus van elektrisch rijden. Niet voor niets voegt Mercedes binnenkort een nieuwe modellijn aan het gamma toe onder de naam EQ en bouwde het merk in Duitsland een eigen batterijenfabriek. Maar wat zal de toekomst nog meer brengen?
Of course it's important that we go electric, because that is the future and we are introducing very many plug-in hybrids already. Of course the key question is always like how much EV, how much plug-in, how much hybrid and so on.
Yeah.
And this is a question which is mainly driven by technology and cost and the infrastructure that is needed for it. So we are definitely sure it's going to go electric.
Yeah.
But you can imagine there are some countries in this world that that don't have the infrastructure in place that fast, for example, for charging cars, than other countries. Mm-hmm. So there will always be some conventional combustion technology around.
Yeah.
The whole business model and who is taking what role is not fully sorted out, which is very similar for battery electric vehicles. I mean, who will be the big battery charging station?
Right, the breakthrough brand.
Investor. Yeah. Will it be the one who makes it? Will it be some financial investor?
And why is it not Mercedes?
Is it the car company?
Yeah.
I mean, the first place we are making cars. That's our expertise and that's our brand. As the world evolves, as we've just been discussing, of course, the energy side around it plays a more and more important role. So, and the energy now offers our customers to buy a battery stack with car batteries in it,
yeah,
for electric vehicles or hybrids, and to put it in your home. And that's another aspect of the CASE world, right? Electric and CASE and the services around the car should, for example, include the energy solution around your home.
Langzaam maar zeker verandert Mercedes-Benz dus in een energieleverancier met oplossingen die verder gaan dan de auto alleen. Maar wat gaat er gebeuren met alle klassieke facetten van het merk? De sierlijke sportwagens, de 12-cilinder limousines en de bulderende AMG's?
You are a car lover, I am a car lover. Will car lovers be left out in the future?
No. It was this interesting statement by a person from Silicon Valley. When you went to the CES, the show in Las Vegas, and yeah, says, now there's many cars there, so the cars become sexy again. And my answer was, the car has always been sexy, but now others have noticed. So definitely cars will remain to be a very emotional product.
Absolutely. Yeah, but we're becoming more a passenger instead of a driver. So where is the passion then?
Yeah, but the question is the passion in driving only? If you observe yourself in a very detailed manner, when you get into your car, that's when the experience starts.
So what do you say to the viewers that are thinking, I will never buy an autonomous electric car?
Buy the right one that doesn't force you to drive autonomously.
Yeah.
But you should have the choice. And you will have the choice.